Come on. I'll give you a hand. Here. Nice place you got here. Kind of make a guy want to puke.
Mach schnell, ihr da. Das sind zwei amerikanische Piloten. Schmutzige Schweine.
Stop shoving.
Yeah, log is full there.
Yeah, what?
Here, careful, William, he knocked his teeth out.
Yeah, come on, get his hand.
Goddamn krauts. Why didn't they treat him before they brought him to the shithole?
There.
Don't worry, fella. We'll have it fixed up in no time.
Yeah, look what I did to him. Those crowds, you can't trust them.
Poor guy, he's in real bad shape.
Bastards. Yeah, you're right.
Careful. Easy does it.
Put him over on the table. This is the best place for now. There you are.
Jesus, this is a hell of a mess. Go find Bucker and bring him over here, drunk or sober. Hey, where about your boys from? When did they capture you?
Yeah, what's the latest news? How fast are we advancing?
My name is Carver, Captain Alan Carver. I was commanding a squadron of light bombers on a mission to intercept the German convoy. I'm afraid the casualty must have been pretty high. Their fighter escorts was unexpectedly heavy. That's my co-pilot, Stain. We got hit and caught fire, so there wasn't any hope of getting back to our base. Bailing out was our only choice, and when we hit the ground, we were picked up by a German patrol.
Hey, there's Baccarat.
Operate at once. A bit of shrapnel in there. Get him ready for me.
Okay, let's go. Who's got the alcohol?
Here it is. But watch out, Backer doesn't drink it all.
Don't worry, this is rubbing alcohol. You ready?
Well, I hope he's up to it.
Let's hope so.
But why don't we have the Germans to look after him? They have to accord to the Geneva Convention. And your medic is stinking drunk.
If we hand him over to the Krauts, you won't see your lieutenant again. That's certain. He's a boozer, but he knows his stuff all right.
Bagara.
Give me a hand.
Thanks.
You must be crazy. No one can operate the state man is in. In civilian life, I'll bet he was a butcher.
Sorry, Captain, but the chap you thought used to be a butcher actually was a very successful surgeon in England. Then his wife got ill. She had a brain tumor, only a few months to live. Seeing her suffering was what made him kill her. And he didn't hide the truth. He claimed it was a mercy killing, only he still got a jail sentence. When he came out, he decided to join up and he got captured immediately. It was in here he started brooding about it. And he started drinking a lot, but he's still a first-class doctor.
Yeah. Scarf.
Hold him. Hold him still. Give us a hand, for God's sake. Get his arm.
Okay, we've got him. Let's get on with it.
Come on, try to resist. He'll be as quick as he can.
Christ! Now hold him tight.
Yeah, glad that's over.
Steady on, wait a minute.
You'll be all right, my boy. Don't worry.
All right, wrap it up. Hey, your health.
Good for you, Baccarat.
You bloody deserve it, mate.
Thank you.
Take it easy, Stain. Take it easy. They're not shooting at us. Calm down now. Calm down.
You better not go outside, Captain. Unfortunately, I think I know what it is. There was an escape set up for tonight. You see an American officer in the next cell, hid in the water tank in the courtyard, waiting for the right moment to make a break for it. He stayed there 4 or 5 hours under the water. Must have breathed through a tube. Poor kid. And it wasn't such a bad plan either. I wonder how the hell they ever found out.
Alles raus! Schnell! Raus von hier!
Prisoner attempted to escape last night. You will notice that he did not succeed. A similar conclusion awaits any of you who wishes to repeat the experiment. We Germans have sharp eyes and good ears. Do not imagine you can escape our vigilance. I have no doubt that this man had accomplices among you. Therefore, you're all to be punished. You will have 5 days of reduced rations. And I warn you that if there are any more of these foolish attempts to escape, your rations will be reduced again. You three, remove that body at once.
Take his other arm.
Dirty bastards. They didn't have to gun him down.
There we go. You're coming along very nicely, laddie. Miracle your wound didn't get infected. But with all the blood you lost, you're going to need to eat well if you're going to get your strength back. Well, I'm afraid the bloody Joes have put us on reduced rations.
Yeah.
But fortunately, I can obtain supplies for my clients down in the village. Of course, I'll have to do without the odd bottle of rot gut, but take care.
Thanks. Lieutenant, tell me, what did Baccarat mean about clients?
Well, my name is Duncan.
Glad to know you.
My pleasure. So you wanted to know about the clients of Baccarat.
Yeah.
He only has one aim in life, and that's where to get the next bottle. And seeing as how a steady supply of liquor isn't easy to get in here, he somehow wangled a permission to treat a few of the farmers who live in the neighborhood.
And they pay him in drinks, eh?
And some food. The Germans know about it. They have to escort him. But they take half of what he gets.
I see that you're reading a French newspaper, so you speak the language, eh?
Yes, sir, I do.
You know, I was with Duncan when the Jerrys caught him. They captured our patrol and, well, since he wasn't taken with us, we thought he got safely away, you know? But you'll never believe how they caught him. He stopped to have a look at the ruins of an old Roman bridge and forgot that he was in enemy territory.
Really, Duncan?
Yeah, I swear it, man. He didn't even know what was happening when they captured him. He's a sort of junior, absent-minded professor. He knows everything about everything. You know he can talk 8 languages?
The way he acts, you can hardly realize he's a prisoner.
Yeah. Is it possible that we've ever managed to escape from this lousy prison camp, eh?
Well, we all wanted to try when we first got here. But so far, everybody who tried has been shot.
Well, there must be some way of getting out of here. We just can't let ourselves sit on our asses forever.
Alles raus! Sinn und Kontrolle!
Damn them.
They do this quite often. It's a house rule. I think they're afraid we might invite girls in our bedroom.
Raus! Schnell!
For me, the problem is simply getting out of here. Once outside, they'll never recapture us. We'll join the partisans. They'll help us get back to our lines.
The catch is, there's no way out of here.
De La Farge.
Present.
Mama Noor.
Yes, up.
Allen.
Present.
Verdier.
Yes.
Marceline.
Yeah.
Picard.
Yes, sir.
Ah, we have here a new guest who has come to join you. A British soldier. He's from an armored division which was stationed in Tunisia and of which he's one of the few survivors. Because his unit was rendered inoperative by the irresistible attack of our glorious Africa Corps. You will observe to what conditions this reduced. And I assure you that all his fellow countrymen will soon suffer a similar fate. England will learn what it means to incur the wrath of our beloved Führer, Heil Hitler! The entertainment is finished. Proceed.
Baccarat.
Yeah.
Duncan.
Present.
O'Reilly.
Right.
McDonough.
Yes, sir.
This kid looks pretty bad. Only God knows what I did to him.
How you feeling, laddie? Where'd they capture you?
I was captured in Tunisia. They got me and 14 others. Only 9 died on the damn trip getting here. I don't know where they are. Listen, I've got dysentery.
Yeah, well, let's have a look at your tongue. You can put that back again. I could be mistaken. But I wouldn't get too close to this chap. He could be highly contagious. All of you keep as far away from him as possible. I'm afraid we must take some precautions immediately. I'll have to go and speak to the commandant. You come with me and translate, right?
Uh-huh.
Tell him we have an urgent message for the commandant. Say it's important, very important.
Okay, okay. Es ist wichtig, sehr wichtig. Wir müssen sofort mit Herrn Oberkommandant sprechen.
Der Kommandant ist sehr beschäftigt. Er lässt Sie rufen, sobald er Zeit hat. Jetzt gehen Sie.
He says the Kommandant is too busy to see you right now. What are you up to anyway?
You'll find out soon enough.
I don't want to go through this a second time. Oh, this is murder. Here, you can have it. It's enough for me now. Go on, take it.
No, I don't want it.
What's the matter? Aren't you coming with us?
No, not me.
Oh, well. Oh. Oh. God.
Johnson.
Present.
Martin.
Yep.
Mulligan.
Here.
O'Connor.
Hi.
Duncan.
Here.
Dal Monte.
Yeah, yeah.
Jefferson.
Here I am.
Jarry.
Yeah.
Verdier.
Present.
Bontard.
Here.
Picard.
Oui.
Fred.
Yep.
MacDonald.
Here.
Delarue.
Here.
Stain. Douglas.
Uh-huh.
Carver. Clark.
Here.
Cully.
Present.
Schnell.
Rein.
Herein. Schnell.
Schnell, always Schnell. What's their hurry?
Tell me what I got, sir. Please, tell me what's the matter. Don't let me die in this awful place, Major. I want to try and get home.
There's nothing to worry about. You'll be all right. Bit of dysentery, that's all. But if you want to get out of here, you'll have to pretend you keep feeling worse. I've got some leaves to rub your skin with to cause blisters. Remember, Letty, you're the only hope we have.
Packer.
What are you doing, Pratt? Looking for someone? I told you to keep away from this man. You may catch his disease. It's extremely dangerous.
I suppose you're immune to this disease, are you? And Duncan and the rest of you, what'd you get? A vaccination? I'm impressed by your professional zeal, Major Baccarat. Maybe you've joined the Temperance Society?
All right, if you see there is nothing wrong with him, get closer. Well, why don't you give him a kiss, eh? Go on. What's holding him back? He's not dangerous, eh? You're not so sure, are you?
Gevangen Baccarat, Commandant.
What do you want, Baccarat?
It's a matter of extreme urgency.
I am listening.
I'm the camp doctor, Herr Commandant. Even if I hold that position unofficially, I do so willingly because I'm the only doctor here, in spite of the rules clearly laid down by the Geneva Convention. There should be one of your doctors in every camp, but you Germans always ignore the regulations, in spite of the protests from the International Committee.
We can put our doctors to a much better use at the front line. I hope, however, this is not what you came here for. As you can see, I am extremely busy.
It's a lot more serious. When that last man arrived, the British soldier, he brought a disease you've no doubt heard about. The plague.
What? What are you trying to say? But it's impossible. How can you be sure of this? I will need to see proof of this.
Four prisoners have already caught the disease. And so have I. Here's your proof.
Let nobody touch this fool, clear? You will be confined to your cell until we can arrange transfer to a suitable isolation clinic. As a doctor, you know what to do to prevent spreading the disease. Now get out.
Yes, sir.
Be ready to leave tomorrow morning.
Johnson.
Yeah.
Barat.
Yeah.
Mulligan.
Present.
O'Connor.
Here.
Dalmonte.
Present.
Jefferson. Jefferson.
Présent.
Jarrier.
Yeah.
Verbier.
Yep.
Bonteur.
Yeah.
Picard.
Yep.
MacDonald.
Yes, sir.
Where did you get
Bannister.
That? It wasn't me who found it. It was the English kid.
Yeah. Oh.
He saw Pratt put it under the pillow of his bunk, and the Germans would have found it this evening when they inspected the dormitory.
Smith! Heffer!
You see?
Well, there's one thing to be grateful for. Now we've got a disease, nobody will search us, will they?
What made you do it, Pratt? You were planning to give us away to the Germans, weren't you? It was your fault if the crowd got a poor guy in a water tank.
No!
And you figured we're going to get the same treatment, didn't you? So you were the one who was spying on us.
No, honestly,
now we see that you won't betray anybody else. And there is only one way to do it. Be you.
Oh, what?
Come away, you friend.
Please, no.
That's what
please,
you deserve. Bastard! Anakin! Anakin!
I've just had a talk with the medical commandant. Evidently, none of our field hospitals are equipped to treat the plague. In short, we have to deal with this problem by ourselves. We must get the sick prisoners out of here right away. Away from the camp. It'll be up to you to eliminate any further risk of contagion. I would say from my own experience that fire is the best solution.
Thank you.
right. All right, easy now. That's it.
You got up.
Come in. Here we go. Right. Okay.
Is good?
Jawohl.
Well, I think that takes care of that. I want you to call the medical command again. Tell them we must have a fumigation unit at once. I want the whole camp disinfected from top to bottom tomorrow.
We better start.
The wrench. Give it here. Come on. Now. There she goes. One down.
Good boy.
Now to the next.
Lass uns noch ein Kilometer fahren. Dann halten wir und in einem Augenblick ist alles tot.
Those damn Krauts. They've got orders to shoot all of us and set fire to the truck.
Just what I expected. A hospital would have been too dangerous.
Yeah.
And provided they get rid of the bodies, they got nothing to worry about. Or they can say the truck was attacked by partisans. And even if the International Red Cross did investigate, they could disclaim any responsibility. Damn Krauts. There'll probably be reprisals back there because we've escaped. Come on, boys, make it snappy.
Get ready. There's only one more after this.
Weißt du, ich habe eine französische Freundin. Blonde Haare, blaue Augen, schlimm. Verschätzt, Mädchen. Ich glaube, sie hat eine Freundin für dich auch.
Go on, get it out.
Yeah, careful. That's it. Now. First man threw his stain on account of his bad arm. Then the mother should follow in case Stain needs any help. Well, then?
All right, ready, everybody.
I suppose Seeker goes after Stain. He's run down from the shits.
Okay, Stain.
Come on, let's go.
Good luck. Roger.
All right, Seeker, you're next.
Come on, let go. Let go!
Your turn. Come on.
Well, down the hatch.
How do you feel?
Oh ja, ist in Ordnung. Nein, vielleicht lieber dorthin. So viele Bäume, es ist besser für das Feuer, ne?
I think they're gonna stop. Yeah, any moment now. Okay, we better get a move on.
Okay, let's go.
Ah, endlich. Alles raus.
Just in time.
Did I really need all these buttons? Let's get into this uniform first. I'll wear one and you wear the other, because you speak German. Ah, here come the others. I sure hope this guy kept a tight asshole when he died. Here, take this. It might come in handy.
And now the partisans and our troubles will be over.
Yeah. You feel all right, laddie?
Yeah, I was so frightened it stopped everything.
Oh, finally free.
My darling husband, Christina. Poor kid. She doesn't know she'll never see him again.
She's a pretty good looker. She'd find another man if she hasn't already found one. Everybody on the alert. There is a roadblock ahead.
Wohin fahren Sie denn? Wissen Sie nicht, dass es hier Partisanen gibt? Geben Sie mir Ihre Papiere. Ausweis, schnell!
Wir müssen drei Männer in Krankenhaus bringen, Herr Leutnant.
Krankenhaus?
Ja doch, Krankenhaus.
Halt! Stehen bleiben!
Let's get out of here.
Come on! Into the woods!
Oh,
Wir sind gerade am Arbeiten. Jawohl, Herr Hauptmann.
Herr Leutnant?
Lassen Sie die zweite Gruppe zurück. Wir machen morgen weiter.
Jawohl.
Hallo? Nein, noch nichts. Wir werden morgen weitermachen. Ich habe schon den Befehl gegeben. Jawohl, Herr Hauptmann. Zu Befehl. Ende.
Bonjour. Tous fermes. Les mains en haut.
Damn it! They've got us.
But they're partisans.
I am the leader of this man. My name is Julien. I imagine you are the prisoners who succeeded in making an escape from the prisoner of war camp yesterday. Isn't that so?
Yeah.
We located your whereabouts yesterday evening, but it seemed desirable to wait the light of day before establishing contact with you. Your escape has caused a lot of excitement at the German headquarters. They are sending in the Gestapo and SS reinforcement to search the area, which means that things will become extremely uncomfortable for us. So we propose to leave immediately. If we remain only a couple of more hours in this place, we will be surrounded by fresh German troops, and we cannot risk an open conflict with the German at this time. We are not strong enough, and we have different plans prepared, which I will reveal to you when the time comes. If you decide to remain with us, your assistance could be extremely valuable, but you must decide at once. What do you want to do?
Of course we stay with you. You're our only hope to get back to our lines.
Then let's move. This woods will soon be infested with a bush. Come on! Very much temptation to fire it. But it will reveal our position to him.
Yeah, damn it.
Ah, that's good. He's going away. We can soon continue our way safely.
You'll be all right in no time, you'll see.
Yeah.
Thank you, pal.
Hey, don't touch it.
Mind if I sit here?
Uh-huh. Want a little wine? Have some.
Oh, I'm sorry. I'm recuperating. I've had trouble with my guts, sort of, you know.
Stomach trouble.
My name is Maria. What's yours?
Dean Seegers. Nobody calls me that. Everyone calls me Bunny.
A rabbit.
Now you see it. Now you don't. Where is it?
It's in there.
Huh? I told you.
Nope.
You put it in the other end. There you did. I saw you. There. I saw it. There.
I would like you to meet my brother Jean. Hi. And my sister-in-law.
Hi there.
Plaisir.
We will have to remain undercover until nightfall. It is very dangerous, the Germans looking for us. Mm-hmm. Our best bet is to travel on it by night, because during the day, the search will be very intense, I think.
Germans! The boys are coming!
Already?
Hey, come on, let's get out of here.
They're just around the bend!
There's no time for us to escape. Come, everyone! We're out of the shed!
Here, let me give you a hand.
No, that's okay, I'll manage.
Come on, kids. Go with your mother.
Now. Allez, venez, les enfants. Vite, 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 il faut rentrer maintenant.
Come on, everybody. Get inside, everyone. Come on. Come on, get in. Relax. Here they come. It will be all right.
Attention! Wir gehen in der Jagd am Mal. Auf zu suchen.
Jawohl, zu befehl.
An die Gebäude.
You. Have you seen any strange men in that area?
No, I've seen no one.
Anybody hiding inside?
No. No, all I know is that I heard the sound of gunfire coming from over there yesterday. It was quite a way off. I don't know what it was about. We're all alone here, me and my family. You can search the place if you don't believe me.
I shall, don't worry. Tell me, do you by any chance have a nice fat pig tucked away in your stable?
No, we don't keep pigs anymore. We've got nothing to feed them. The last pig we had was requisitioned by some of your troops over 2 months ago. And since then, well...
Ach so!
The bastards, look, they brought dogs.
They're coming over.
Made it. We haven't a chance.
There is only one thing to do.
Shit!
You have to come with us now. You can't stay here. It's suicide for you to remain. The Germans are bound to return.
No, Julian, no. To travel with the children would be impossible. You know? I will say you threatened to kill us if we didn't hide you. No harm will come to us, don't worry. Now you have to go. Bonne chance, Julien.
I'm so frightened.
Don't worry, dear.
About the children.
Centipede is taking a honeymoon because the chocolate is finished. Repeat, the chocolate is finished. Here is a message for Lame Wolf.
That's us.
Lame Wolf is to go to the fold and steal the little lamb, but not to eat it. Puss in Boots will be waiting in the usual place as soon as the omelette is fried. Mary had...
The little lamb is General Kaufman, and we have to capture him alive. The operation is to take place tomorrow night, because tomorrow is the day we have to move. The omelette that is fried. I tell you the details.
Oh, Julien.
What is it, Maria?
No. The Germans have just arrested your brother and his wife. One of the neighbors came to tell me. They're going to be executed for hiding you. They've put the boys in the orphanage already.
But I can't do that. We must find some way to free them.
It is impossible to do anything. Only I can help them. Tomorrow I shall go and surrender to the Germans. They have been trying to capture me for years. They will be delighted when I give myself up. I am sure the Germans will release my brother's wife at least.
No, Julien. You must not even begin to think of such a thing. Now that we undertake Operation Kaufman, you know how important it is. We have worked for months. We cannot go ahead without you. Let me go in your place, Julien.
You are very generous, François. But I am the one the Germans want, as you well know. And we dare not attempt any type of rescue action for fear it might compromise Operation Kaufman. You'll work alone. You can easily do it without me.
Julien, it's our fault if you're in these troubles. If you hadn't given us a hand, your brother would have never been arrested. We want to repay you by helping the operation, but we want to be treated like the rest of you.
Very well. I think everybody here will agree that we can use the assistance of our companions. That's settled then. Now I have to explain the plan of action. Here's the pasture where the little lamb is grazing.
The German headquarters.
You will have to get past the sentries, find your way into General Kaufman's office, and bring him out alive. He will be a very useful prisoner for the Allies, as he's the only one who knows the defense plans for this sector. Your German-speaking friend will be most helpful.
Why did you join the partisans, Maria?
The Boche killed all my family, all of them. My husband and my beautiful children. But you see, it must finish soon. You seem young for a soldier. Don't worry, you'll see your home again. And live long.
Thank you.
the man you're looking for. My name is Julien. Take me to your commanding officer.
Yeah, come and see me. Come.
I must admit, I admire your courage. You took a great risk with no guarantee of success. But your brother cannot be pardoned. He will be executed along with yourself for giving assistance to the partisans. I can, of course, execute the woman as well. After all, you are all in our hands. We Germans, however, take no pleasure in executing the fair sex, especially if it's a woman with children. Therefore, I will accept your sacrifice, Julien. The woman is to be released at once.
Sitzen! Die Doppelreihe! Schnell, antreten! Fertig! Schießen! Und den dritten Marsch!
Do you choose to have a blindfold?
No.
Come here! Up! Shut up!
Moment mal, bitte. Wir haben Ordnung, dass Befehl die Exekution...
Abstellen! Ich brauche den schriftlichen Befehl!
Ja.
Hurry up, Julien. Find your brother a safe hiding place.
Okay, go.
Come on, boys. Let's get out of here.
I hope the fear the lad is dead.
Hitler, Herr Oberleutnant. We were not expecting visitors here today.
I've come from the Office of High Command under secret orders. The visit was not announced in order to maintain maximum security. I have to deliver this prisoner to General Kaufmann. He has important information to give him.
Kaufmann!
It would appear that your headquarters are harboring a spy.
A spy here? Impossible.
Heil Hitler! Very good with that man.
I've been ordered to take him to General Kaufmann.
Very well. Come and see.
nicht rein. Ich habe ein schönes Mädchen gesehen.
Ich auch.
Gehst du auch gerne spazieren mit einem französischen Mädchen? Morgen.
Bonjour.
Ist Bonjour alles, was du kannst sagen?
Ich kann Allons faire l'amour sagen. Mademoiselle, Allons faire l'amour.
Guten Tag.
Aber sie ist natürlich für mich gekommen.
Mademoiselle, Allons faire l'amour.
Allons, gehen wir. Nein, ich glaube, sie will es mit mir, Liebe machen.
Come on, we've captured the machine gun.
Great. Then we can go and join the others outside the stockade.
Let's go.
Come in.
Heil Hitler! Lieutenant Kranz reporting, sir.
I don't think I ever met you, Lieutenant Kranz. Do you want to tell me something?
Yes, General Kaufman. I have orders to deliver to you personally. I see you're an expert on Renaissance painting, sir.
It's the only thing I enjoy about this war. At first, I was going to be given Africa. But there, you can only do archaeology. No. This is my only interest. This kind of art. You'd be amazed. Had you seen that painting? A mere brown crust. But with my infallible instinct, I realized there was something underneath. I knew it. Now, the painting which is emerging is by Leonardo or his school.
You're right. And he did spend his declining years in France as an artist at court. Wouldn't it have been wonderful to have lived in that period and to have known artists as great as Leonardo? I feel very envious of you, General, living in this splendid palace with all these works of art. You're very lucky.
You are a true German. For we Germans are highly civilized and cultured people. We appreciate that we must always protect these works of art. It's a most important responsibility. Imagine how the Americans would act. They no doubt use these paintings to light fires. But we will prevent them from doing so. Look at the exquisite line of that hand, for example. Marvelous, is it not? I'd love to restore this painting myself. By the way, you still haven't told me the reason you're here. And who is this?
All right, General, don't move or I'll shoot. Hold it there.
Do you want to try anything?
Hurry up, get his uniform.
Just my size. You sure like this beer.
Now you're going to open the safe for us and hand over the defense plans in it.
But the safe is not in this room. It's in my office on the opposite side of the building.
Well, we've come this far, boys. We can't stop now, even if we wanted to. And I don't want to.
You'll have to lead us there. And no funny tricks, or you'll get a lot of holes in that nice uniform.
Heil. General Kaufmann, I have to speak to you on a question of great... But haven't we met?
That's impossible. He's just got back from the east.
But that soldier is one of the prisoners who escaped from my camp. I recognize him.
Get moving.
They should be out before much longer. Apparently, they've had no trouble yet. Everything looks quiet.
Hey, Kamerad, du kannst doch hier nicht bleiben. Hier ist reserviert alles. Für das Stabskommando. Verstehst du mich nicht? Nimm dein LKW mit, da ist der richtige Parkplatz. Verstanden?
Open it. Go on, hurry up. Move.
That bastard killed him. Come on, let's beat it. Here. Let's go.
Lepers, look out!
Give me a hand, quick. Come on, let's get out of here.